Hello, photopiler Rafael Lebar here. Today again I'm in Menorca in Guinigaus with the great Antoni Clavero. You can see him there. He's already working for the composition for today. And we're here to show you how to use a END filter, a graduated END filter, to phase these high dynamic range scenes. In this case, to even the light from the sky, between the sky and the foreground. So in one single exposure we can capture a photo correctly exposed, thanks that the END filter will be blocking the light in the sky. So let's get started. Well guys, this is Photo Pills. We are at the right shooting spot at the red pin position. The sun is setting in the direction of the thick orange line, and at the moment the sun is at the direction of the thin orange line. So we know at all time the light direction, and this helps us choose our shooting spot. Tony's here looking for the best composition and the best shooting spot. Also, in the planner you can tap on the AR button here at the bottom and visualize the path of the sun through your phone, and as you see it matches the real sun, which is so cool. I was telling you, here we have Antoni Clavero, who is looking for the best compo in this location.
Hello, Photopiller.
Hello, Tony. Show me the compo. Come on.
Yes, the compo is a simple compo. It's minimalist compo with the rock in the foreground.
Nice, nice, nice. I like it. Yes. And this beautiful blue sky above it.
And I need a filter, a END filter, for match the sky and the rock.
Yeah.
Okay.
To match the exposure,
or the exposure.
Yeah, when you're facing like a dynamic, a huge dynamic range of scene, END filter helps you.
The dynamic range of the roads is more low than the than the sky.
Fantastico. And for the photo, what are you gonna use?
Yes, I use a Z6.
Your camera.
Yes, with 18 millimeter phase Milbus and a study tripod.
Yeah,
and
nice.
With a END filter of three stops
END filter.
Yes.
So let me show me the filter and see.
This is the filter.
Yeah, we see that clearly.
Okay,
on top is darker and it goes from stronger to softer at the bottom, right?
I put in the first rank. Okay, in the LCD, Rafa, come here. Yes. You see
it? Yeah, clearly I see the effect.
Yes. This is the effect of filter.
Nice.
I put here near to the
And what happens when you have like a subject that's vertical with this kind of filters? You need to be very careful, right?
Yes, very careful. I go with in the middle of the rock and put above the rock. Now here, this is the right.
Yeah. And you're using a Lucroid
END Lucroid three stops soft. Yes.
And and the filter holder is also Lucroid, right?
I had the possibility of test with a filter of four stops, and you see the effect, a big effect with four stops, very strong effect. Okay. But
I see.
It's very strong. The three stop filter is the
one to go today.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, what other filters or END filters do you use usually regularly? You use the three stops and
Stops and rarely four stops.
Four stops.
Yes. And three stops is the best for me.
Great.
And two stops inverse, reverse two stops. Yeah. But in another video.
We'll show the rig.
Yes, we show.
And for the photo, where are you focusing?
I'm focusing in this case, it's very easy. I'm focusing on the road. It's a minimalist photography on the road. No, not a cheesy perfocal. It's only focus on the road and calculate the exposure time, okay?
Yeah.
And put the END filter, okay?
Where do you measure light? Do you measure light?
I'm metering to the rocks.
With the filter on or without the filter?
Without the filter, to the rocks.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
So you measure light without the filter on the rocks.
Yes, 120.
And what's the shutter speed you get?
120. One moment.
So shutter speed 120.
120.
F16. ISO 100.
ISO 100. And the histogram, the live histogram is perfect.
Great. Okay. Fantastico.
But if you see it's a very light in the sky. Okay. In the right side of the histogram.
Yeah. Very bright.
I put the filter.
Yeah.
The histogram
changes
a lot of
yeah,
and it's more light,
balanced.
Great. Instagram.
Okay, fantastico.
And shoot. Take a photo.
Okay,
shoot. This is the photo.
Nice, I like it.
Yes, minimal. This is Instagram.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful.
Super.
I love seeing you using filters.
Yes, I love.
You like, you tell me the truth. You love filters.
You love.
you love filters.
You love filters.
Well, Tony, what can you sum up the steps to shoot this shot with a GND filter?
Yes, it's very easy, Rafa. The first step is focus on the rocks, not hyperfocal, only on the rocks. The second step is metering. High dynamic range in the roads and in the sky, yes.
So the metering, yes, the two spots, so
two spots,
you know,
okay,
the stops difference.
Yes. In this case, I meet a three stop, okay, and only put into the holder the GND filter of three stops of Lucroid and take a photo.
That's simple. Awesome. Well, guys, if you want to keep learning on long exposure photography or the use of any lens filter, we're gonna leave a link in the description of this video. Download our guides on long exposure and lens filters. We're gonna leave the link in the description of this video and in the first comment below. And if you like this video, give us a like, subscribe, and we'll see you in next Wednesday.
Yes.
And remember that you have the power to imagine,
plan,
and shoot
legendary photos.
Bye bye.
Bye.
Ciao.